الذي خلق الموت والحياة. سبحان الله. Look what قتادة said رحمه الله. أذل الله ابن آدم بالموت. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed the son of Adam in a state of humiliation because of death. وَجَعَلَ الدُّنْيَا, and he made the dunya for the son of Adam a place where he lives and dies. You're born in it and you die in it. The scholars by the way say, why did Allah say death before life? He created الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَى والحياة. Why? For you to remember that what awaits all of us is what? Death. Another explanation by the way, قالوا لأن الموت هو الأصل. ما هو we go through four stages. No mention. هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر لم يكن شيئا؟ He had no mention. He had no existence. He did not exist. Then you were called to life, then you will die, and then you will rise again and never die. But hopefully you're going to be in the right place, because there is a bad place out there where actually they will wish to die. وَنَادَوْ يَا مَالِكُ, they will call upon the warden, the angel who's in charge of hell, لِيَقْضِ عَلَيْنَا رَبُّكُ. Can your Lord make us die? قَالَ إِنَّكُمْ مَاكِثُونَ. No, you're staying. كيف تكفرون بالله? How in the world do you make sense disbelieving in Allah? وكنتم أمواتا, when you were dead. فأحياكم, then he given you life. ثم يميتكم, then he will cause you to die. ثم يحييكم. Look at this number here. There are three of them that you can establish. There is only one missing out of these four, which the people do not believe in, is the resurrection. But already the three, already you can prove the three. You were dead. You came to life. Can you deny death? Can you? So what is left? And there are people who do not believe in it. One of them came to the Prophet, after we become bones, الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةً. Can you go into how he created you first? الذي خلق الموت والحياة. One of the explanations, يا إخوة, I came across, I believe in الجلالين, خلقكم للموت. He created you to die. Sure. And think about it. Because quite frankly, we were asked to talk about death. صحيح ولا لا؟ What is the problem with people? They forgot about death. They cannot deny it, but they are what? In a state of what? I call it ghafla. The word forgetfulness, ghafla is heedlessness. You see the difference between heedlessness, الغفلة والنسيان. In nisyan, we're not held accountable for it, that you forget something, خلاص. إن الله, Allah has pardoned my ummah for what they forget. But الغفلة, what الغفلة? الغفلة that you know it, but you care less. You're not caring about it. That's الغفلة. That's الغفلة. This is الغفلة, heedlessness. It's called heedlessness, state of heedlessness. That you know that there is something out there, but you what? You don't do something about it. Like, that's why you're supposed to do what? You're supposed to talk about death. Actually, there are some practices in the religion that was legislated just to remember death. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, I banned you earlier from visiting the graves. Now go visit the grave. Why? كنت قد نهيتكم عن زيارة القبور ألا فزورها فإنها تذكركم بالموت. في لفظ بالموت, it will remind you of death. عودوا المريض, visit the sick. واتبعوا الجنائز, follow the janazas. فإنها تذكركم بالموت, it will remind you of death. أكثروا ذكر هازم لذات الموت. Mention in abundance the destroyer of all pleasures, death. الوقت in some communities when you talk about death, يا عم, don't be pessimistic كده, talk about us about life, talk about fun. طب ما هو الذي خلق الله did not say خلق الحياة والموت، خلق الموت والحياة، الحياة الثانية، the next life. Why are we here؟ ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. We're here to be tested. And remember this يا إخوة. The test in two areas. بسموه الابتلاء القدري. The test pertaining to your قدر. قدر. Allah, you did not choose your birthday. You did not choose your father, mother. You did not choose your birthplace. Nor you choose your death. Or where you will die. All of this is written, by the way. you have no say about this. It's already what qaddar. Now, if it is good, then you should be what? Should be what? Grateful. طيب. If it is not according to you, then you should be what? Patient. عجبا لأمر المؤمن فإن أمره كله له خير. I'm amazed at the lifestyle of a believer. It's all good for him. إن أصابته ضراء صبر. When he's inflicted with a calamity, he's patient. By the way, you don't have to accept الرضا, عبودية الرضا. There are two servitudes when you're inflicted with a calamity. The first servitude that you have to exercise patience. Then after patience comes what? You accept. خلاص قدري هذا. ربنا ابتلاني ده خلاص حرضة. الرضا يعني takes time. You accepting it takes time. ولذلك يا إخوة, I came across this beautiful. You know when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم son Ibrahim died, what happened? He stood by his bedside and tears came down. I believe عبد الرحمن بن عوف was standing next to him رضي الله عنه. He said, يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, يعني even you cry. He said, إن القلب لا يحزن, the heart grieves, وإن العين لا تدمع, the eyes shed tears, وإن لفراقك يا إبراهيم لمحزنون, and we're saddened because of your death, O Ibrahim, ولكن لا نقول ما يغضب الرب. But I'm not going to say anything which would reflect my displeasure with Allah's or being not contented يعني with Allah's decree. I'm going to accept Allah's decree. There is one of the predecessors, his name is Al-Fudayl ibn Ayyad. Pay attention to this. كلام هذا يعني Al-Fudayl ibn Ayyad used to have a son, his name is Ali. So pious and righteous, this young man. You tell you when he would pray behind the Imam and the Imam would recite verses about عذاب and he would get shocked in the Salah. فعلي died. So while Al-Fudayl is burying him, he's laughing. So that's cool. Al-Fudayl is known of his righteousness and piety. The Prophet is crying and Al-Fudayl, أيهما أكمل؟ Who is complete here؟ قالوا رسول الله. They said the messenger of Allah. Why? Because he went into the sequence. الفضيل the sequence what? He got الرضا before what? الصبر. لا مفروض صبر then what? هذا this is the natural course. But الفضيل what? He messed up العبوديات. Don't we have sometimes people who are really hit with a calamity and then he's like, don't we see? That's exactly what happened. But basically you're supposed to be what? Patient. That's why Shia Rawafid every year. What happened? I mean, this the death of al-Husayn. Been hundreds of years now. I mean, you should be having rida now. بقدر الله. قدر الله خلاص قدر. But you go back now and you... There is no need for this. وينس قدر. فالذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوه. So the first area of test is the area of القدر. In my opinion, in my opinion, this is an easy area because, quite frankly, what are you going to do? Allah ordained upon you that this is going to happen to you. You tell me what. من كان يظن أن لن ينصره الله في الدنيا والآخرة يعمل يا شيخ عيد فليمدد بسبب إلى السماء ثم ليقطع فلينظر هل يذهبن كيده ما يغيظ. أنت متضايق من قدر الله اعمل حبل كده في أروب in the ceiling وموت روح هتعمل إيه؟ ما هو القدر the test in the area of القدر is easy quite frankly but it takes إيمان. Here is the second area where we're tested, which is actually the most difficult. The shar'i test. L'ibtila'i shar'i. Why it's difficult? Because you have a freedom choice. Allah giving liya al-amana. Which the heavens and the earth refused what? Inna aradna al-amana, which is the freedom of choice. They call the freedom. Inna aradna al-amana ta'ala al-samawati wal-ardi wal-jibali fa'abayna an yahmilnaha wa ashfaqna minha wa hamalaha al-ih? Al-insan. Al-insan, al-ins wal-jinn. Jinn and ins. Say la ilaha illallah, let me think about it. But the heavens and the earth and the rest of the creations. ثم استوى إلى السماء وهي دخان فقال لها وللأرض ائتيا طوعا أو كرها قالت إيه أتينا إيه طائعين. Allah said to the heavens and the earth, would you like to have the freedom of choice? No. Please. So the type of test, الابتلاء الشرعي is difficult. Because they have a freedom of choice. Look at the angels. Why the angels are not in trouble? Why? Because they don't have what? لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون يخافون ربهم من فوقهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. Angels don't. Add to this, we have enemies. I call them the three. The first enemy is right here. Inside you, nafs. Allah giving you a nafs that wants what? The share in the dunya. Akhira nafs? No. Now. I want now. Ya nafs aib, fi hellfire, fi. Ya fatah da, khalas. Allah knows. The first enemy is your nafs. Then comes in what? Your jinni. Everyone has a jinni. And then comes in what? The human jinni. The human shaytan يعني. وفي شياطين الإنس وشياطين الجن. هو الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. قال سفيان الثوري أحسن عمل أي أخلصه وأصوبه. You noticing يا إخوة that Allah did not say أحسن أعمالا. It's not plural. It's what? Singular. By the way, we're all in this life looking for one عمل which will save us. Don't think that we're after quality, after quantities. You're really after one عمل which will save you. ولذلك أيكم أحسن عملا. Now focus on sincerity and focus on adhering to the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وهو العزيز الغفور. Now if you fail the test, if you fail the test, العزيز will deal with you. The mighty. And if you pass the test, then you're going to get what? الغفور. That tells you also, regardless of what you do, you excel, sincerity, you still need what? مغفرة. No one is perfect.